Hello, hello, and welcome back to Inspirations, where you can find encouragement to inspire a life. This is Dana Susan Beasley of angelarts.biz, and I'm starting a new series on falling in love with the bridegroom. Before I get started, if you would like to get a free Valentine's Day package, including a guide on what to do when you've lost that loving feeling, two original gorgeous floral art prints, and a sweet Valentine's printable, look below for the link. Now, I know that Valentine's Day has passed, but you can always send a late gift or save it till next year. This PDF resource is valued at $55 and will be an encouragement this coming Valentine's Day and beyond. So, now let's go to today's devotional, and I will start with prayer. Dear Lord, I thank you for the Ruths in our lives, those who are loyal and who are obedient to you, and I thank you for your presence that can do so much healing and can take away our bitterness and give us new life. And I pray this in your precious name. Amen. And you may have guessed that I will be reading from Ruth, or will be discussing Ruth, particularly the first chapter. And I'll just read one of the key verses, famous verses, in this chapter. And I'm reading it from the English Standard Version, verses 15 through 18. So what happened is that Naomi and her husband left Bethlehem, and they went to another country, to Moab, and while they were there, her husband died, and her sons-in-law died, or her sons died, and so she had two daughters-in-law, and one went back to her people, but Ruth refused, and this is what she said. So Naomi says, "See, your sister-in-law," oh, and by the way, this is the word of the Lord, and she said, "See, your sister-in-law has gone back to her people and to her gods. Return after your sister-in-law." But Ruth said, "Do not urge me to leave you or to return from following you. For where you go, I will go, and where you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people, and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die, and there will I be buried. May the Lord do so to me, and more also, if anything but death parts me from you." And when Naomi saw that she was determined to go with her, she said no more. So, from this passage, what can we determine that the bridegroom, or Jesus, is like? Once upon a time, a bitter woman was hard-pressed and blamed God. But she journeyed with her daughter-in-law back to the land of promise. Against hope, she went back to her people, her daughter-in-law faithfully abandoning all to stay with her. Little did she know the great things that would happen as a result of their obedience, loyalty, and love. She got back at the beginning of harvest, and though she could not see it, her bitter life was about to overflow with blessing, not only for her, but for the whole world. So what is my response? When I can't see the reason, when circumstances are painful and bitter, I need to walk through in obedience. Go where he's calling me, no matter what the cost. When I do so, a bountiful harvest is around the corner, not only for me, but for all around me. These words are so, so true. It's so easy when bad things happen to blame God. It's so easy to get bitter. But when we walk in faithfulness and obedience, then God brings his presence, and that's truly wondrous. And I think my computer may have shut down. Hold on. So, sorry about that. So, what was God saying to me as I meditated on this passage? Walk through in obedience. My harvest is coming. I will be blessed and bless many others. Life seems chaotic and out of control, and as I said before, I wrote this back in, I don't even remember, years ago. And it's still true today. My life is pretty chaotic and out of control sometimes. But God has a future plan for me of abundance, and I can count on Him. And He's the same for you. Being in His presence is the most important thing. And I love how, if you read Ruth 1, and I suggest you do, you will see that it's interesting how the scripture says that God, let me read that directly, rather than off the top of my head, because I'll get it wrong. But I like how, you know, they were in Moab because they were starving in Bethlehem, and then their sons took these wives. But then after the men died, Naomi heard in the fields, she heard way out there in Moab that the Lord had visited His people and given them food. And I think that what we need most is God's presence. That's really what we need most. It reminds me of Jesus when He met the Samaritan woman and the disciples came and said, "Here's your food." And He said to them, "My food is to do the will of My Father." So it's really in His presence that we find comfort, and then we find that harvest. It's easy for us to blame Him, but He has a plan for us, and He will bring that harvest. And we need to be faithful and obedient. All right, so that's all I have. I'm going to end in prayer, and then we will wrap it up for the day. All right. So, dear Lord, we pray for Your presence in our lives today. Whatever we're going through and whatever circumstances have come our way, and maybe perhaps we're blaming You. It's such a natural thing to do. And just help us to see You and to be obedient and to trust in You and to be loyal and to cling to You no matter what. And we thank You that You will be bringing us the harvest, and we will go from bitter to abundance and overjoyed. And it's in Your precious name I pray. Amen. All right, so that's all for the day. Tomorrow I'll continue my series on falling in love with the bridegroom. And again, if you want the free Valentine's Day package, check the link below. I'm going to be only offering it this week, and then I'll be offering something else. So, would you like to go deeper with the scriptures? Find out more about my Becoming God's Bride Bible study. In fact, it will teach you how to study the Bible. Check that out also in the description box below. So with that, I'm going to leave you with my favorite blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you peace. This is Dana Susan Beasley of AngelArts.biz. Together, may we reach new heights and lives of peace.